Hey guys, welcome back for another episode. As you can see, the fishing gear is a bit of a mess at the moment, but I haven't had much time to sort it out. As I said in the last episode, we'll be swapping this episode up a little bit, changing the orientation round and how we present it. So hopefully it works out well. Give us some feedback in the comments if you think we can change anything. Because this is mainly kingfish in this episode. We're lucky enough in the middle of winter that at a certain time of the year for about 2 weeks, usually when the swell gets pretty big, the king's food source gets pushed inside the inlet and the fish come in to feed. Not very often we get this, but we're lucky enough to have kind of picked it up early and chased them this year in the shallow water in about 1 to 2 metres of water, which would go pretty hard. So as you'll see in this episode, we've got some great footage. I'll give you a bit of a rundown on what we look for and what we use. It's where we find the bait, where we find the fish, kind of when they're there, tides, that sort of thing, to try and give you guys a bit of an insight of how we catch them and how we find these fish. This is a perfect example. A little bit of structure with deep water and current pushing up against it. The bait fish will get washed up from the deep up into the shallow water, and that's where the fish will attack. These fish also seem to really like a lot of water movement, so that's another thing to look for as well. This is the other side of that structure. So quite often we see fish free swimming across the sand, and they'll push the bait, like I said before, back up towards the rock and attack these fish on the surface. You'll find these fish pretty much in clear water around the high tide, give or take an hour each side of the tide. As long as you can find a bit of structure, which they love, and the bait, you'll usually find the fish. So this is generally what bait looks like on your sounder. As you can see here, the bait's all split up. It usually would have been sitting together, but it's all split up. Something's been attacking it, so that's a good sign. And it, quite often the predators will sit down in these little holes and hunt from beneath. You quite often see them hunt from above, but that's what bait looks like, split up. Some of these marks will be some predators, but... So pretty much we've just rocked up to a spot. We know they're here, they're never ever under here, but we finally found them under here. We've seen them free swimming on the sand, so we're throwing everything we can. Baits, lures, yep. Stick baits, poppers, just trying to see what they're going to eat.
Swallow the dog.
Yeah.
Oh!
Yeah, it hit the lure, it didn't swallow the dog. That's right where it was. Oh, where Riley's lure bait is now.
Oh, something.
Right, it's lost the absolute donkey. Go, Louie, go, Louie, go, Louie. Oh, no. Look at them all running. This is it. In the gear. Look at them under the bridge over there. Around those pylons. Drop. He's still on.
So especially when these fish are around snags, you do have to use pretty big gear. Like, we use anything from 80 to 100 pound mainline to 80 to 120 pound leader. And this is the sort of thing we throw as far as lures are concerned. So big poppers and big stick baits. Don't be afraid about the size, because these fish will smash these big lures.
So after getting smoked on the 100 pound a day, making up some pre-made leaders for tomorrow, crimped onto 8-0 circles, Gamagatsu, and a couple of 9-0 live bait Gamagatsu. So hopefully we can stop one.
Morning guys, so it's 5 a.m. As you can probably tell, I'm half asleep. We're still dark outside. I'm gonna go throw the boat in, pick up one of our mates, Jack. We'll go see if we can get one.
Having a quick look round, and before too long, we ended up finding fish.
Later. Get the gaff. I'll go.
Yeah, you can do it.
Oh, well.
Can you see?
Yeah.
Oh, come up here. Yeah.
Yeah.
Slap
a little bit.
Slap a little bit.
There's got to be a rinse mine coming in.
I don't know.
Turn the gaff the other way over at 10.
Over the top.
Tell me what you want, Brad.
No, you just keep down like that. That's it, over his head like that. Reach over the top. Zip it in. Got him.
Hey, buddy!
No, he's only a little one.
Oh, well, he's a keeper. No, now we got a fish in the boat with the gaff. Yeah, there's no need to gaff any more fish. That fish is enough to feed everybody in the boat and probably some more people we know. So don't like to keep too many fish. One every now and then's good, but try and keep in mind, if you let these fish go, they're going to be there for you and everyone else to catch. So there's no point keeping too many.
Is this recording, Rye?
Yeah.
Rye? Am I recording, Riley?
Let's drive away from that boy over there.
Get the dog!
Let's get away from that friend boy over there.
No, you want to stay away from any snags, because it doesn't matter whether it's 10 metres away or 100 metres away, these fish will see a snag and they will go for it and brick you on them, so keep that in mind as well.
Yeah.
I can feel the hook's gonna pull soon. A bit more up to into the current.
Hence we got the net out. Instead of gaffing fish, we'll try and catch them and then release them safely. Gives you some idea of the power these fish have. That's a pretty solid hook, and she's actually just snapped off at the end. So, got to keep a good gear up to these.
Go! Stop! Keep going. Missed you, right?
Yeah. Come to the side.
Here you go. You all right? Oh. Back up?
No.
What up?
Hey, bang, little.
Steer it up.
We did lose both those fish in the net at the side of the boat, which sucked. It would have been good to get a few pictures with them, but like I said before, we don't keep every one of these fish we catch. We try and just keep one and then let the rest go. So at the end of the day, it's not that much of an issue. Got to keep these fish in the ocean.
So we didn't fish today. Bit of a rainy weather and stuff. So just getting set up for tomorrow. See if we can get a few snapper. And after that, probably go and throw some hard bodies for some kingfish. For the kings. A bit of a schmuzzle at the moment. 14,000 twin power Shimano. Usually run it on this longer rod, the Samaki Vanquish. But at the moment I got it on the short rod so I can try and winch them out from under the snags.
Are we all locked?
We're locked and loaded. Got the ammo. Fresh ammo.
Got a gun.
Just trying to escape the ammo. Salty crew.
Salty crew. Here, bruh. You can't chew there. All illegal.
Bad.
Yeah, fuck off.
Did you get that
on film? I missed it. Lick it though. I got
saved me real life.
Sorry, bro.
I've got that.
That was me real side.
Yeah. Yeah, you can have me trackies.
You saved me just to get I'm in.
That's all I heard. Look at him on the wall.
They're jumping in the sandbar, bro. Look at him.
Oh, God, there, God, there, God, there, God, there. Oh, God.
If you're hanging around and you can't catch a fish or don't see fish, move on to the next spot because they're obviously not eating in that spot. Sometimes you see them and they're just not eating, so move on to the next spot.
Reverse?
Yep.
That's a big shark. Actually, I'll bug fucked up.
Get away from that wall. Here he comes.
Another important thing that you might look past is communication. Now, as long as you've got someone to drive that knows what they're doing, communication between the person on the rod, the person landing the fish, and the driver is key, and it will land your fish.
The squid. Yeah, boys.
Dog.
Yeah, boys.
Yeah.
Happy
birthday. Happy birthday, my man.
I only took a couple of squidlies.
Dude, you fall over.
I want to get the squid in its mouth.
Yeah, bro. Get the dogs. Yeah, Lukey. What a fish. It's pissing all over you, the dog.
Yeah, I'm putting this.
as you can see, I finally got the hard top on. It's a hard top that I made to suit my boat and our fishing needs, so that worked out well, and I'm real glad to actually finally get it on the boat and use it to keep some of those rays off our head.
Oh, you're on here. Yeah, wind it in.
Hold up.
Just hold it up tight, Lou. Yeah. Hold it up tight. Yeah, go, keep going forward, Lukey. Keep going forward.
Your line.
Yeah, it's all right. Yeah, keep holding it.
You're going well. Keep that pressure on.
Yeah, keep going. You're right. Keep going forward.
At this pace?
Yeah, keep going at this pace. Just stop. Just keep winding, Lou. Keep winding. Keep going forward, Lukey.
Yeah,
pump and wind.
Get up in the rocket launcher seat.
Yeah, you might have to take over.
You want me to take over?
Yeah. Yeah, fish in the boat.
Watch out. Look out.
You've got him, mate. Get that gap.
Six.
Where is it?
Clicked
up.
You filming? Yeah. Is it? Can you have a look?
Yeah.
Is it hard?
Yeah. We need him out in the paddock. Bad fish. Well done, Luce, that's your fish too.
I don't know if you can hear us discussing, but the reel's locked up, the drag ceased, so I'm on full drag, which is not real good. You want these fish to run sometimes. Full drag, so it's going to be a bit of a fight to the end, this one.
This is the worst bit, getting him into the boat.
Probably back that drag off just a little bit, Luke, so it's not like we're just in gear. Lukey, happy birthday, bro! Get the fucking dog! Hey, gonna pat that dog! Seize.
What does that mean?
Not good if you take the run. Just clear the boat, watch his rod.
Do you care where I gap it?
Just watch that. You've got him, mate. Just nurse him. That drag's fucking. This is gonna be a make or break.
Get that gap into him.
Looks like.
Is there a second gap?
just like to say, thanks heaps for watching again. I appreciate everybody's views. Every like, comment, view, subscribe makes a huge difference. So I'd just like to thank you guys once again for getting on board and supporting us. I really appreciate it. All the boys really appreciate it, so thank you. We've also got a little bit of work done on the boat. We've finally got the roof on, which I'll show you guys. Got a heap of wiring and things tidied up or rewired, so really happy with that. Live bait tank in, everything's pretty much sorted, ready for paint, so I just got to do a little bit more welding on the hull, tidy a few things up, and it should be done. At the end of the year, once the big pelagics like the marlin, the mackerel, the tuna, the kings, all those sorts of things start to come on, got to do a giveaway. So one of you guys, one of our viewers, I'm going to give you the opportunity to come out on the boat with us. Everything paid for, fuel paid for, food paid for, beers if you want paid for. Come out for the day, we'll put you onto some good fish, have a laugh, get some footage. But I'd just like to let you guys know that it is in the pipeworks and upcoming. Thanks for watching another episode, and we'll try and keep the footage rolling in for you. Thank you.